The Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Finance, Ramadan Gobi, made the remarks while appearing before the Budget Committee, where the committee chairperson, Patrick Isiagi Opolot, put the government to task to improve domestic health services to stop the embarrassing practice of government officials dying abroad while seeking treatment.
We should be having good standards of health centers here. We want to see PSST is sick, is in Gombe Hospital, in Butambala. But you remember even Gombe Hospital, to improve it, see, Parliament here, who intervened in our reallocation, you call distorting. You want to call this, but now you go and fall sick in Butambala. You will not bother going far to Mulago.
In his response, Gobi proposed that funds allocated for treatment of government officials abroad be repurposed to improve quality of healthcare services to the population, to save the country from this hemorrhage of funds spent abroad as officials seek for better medical care.
The money which goes abroad, why don't we use it to improve our systems? And because I've seen many Ugandans who live longest, and we are all, you know, treated here. In other words, the system is not that bad. But sometimes I think some people go abroad for other reasons. We need also to address all of these issues.
The late Doholo District Woman Member of Parliament, Cecilia Ogwal, is the latest government official to die abroad while seeking treatment. She succumbed to cancer of the pancreas in India. It is estimated that government spends over 400 billion shillings on treatment of its officials abroad. Gobi emphasized that the money spent on treatment abroad benefits a handful of people because most Ugandans seek medical services in local facilities that need money to be improved to minimum standards.
Very powerful comment. We don't want to die abroad and so on.
And we make speeches praising you.
Yes.
For nothing.
They brought me some thoughts. This August House and the government of Uganda, you know, there are so many Ugandans. We are 40, officially, about 43.7 million people. There are very few Ugandans who go abroad. Others live here, they go to our medical facilities.
Meanwhile, members on the Budget Committee have asked the Ministry of Finance to restore taxation on gold exports. According to the Auditor General's report of the financial year ended June 2023, the government has lost 52.2 billion shillings between 2021 to 2023 due to failure to collect taxes on unprocessed gold, which ACT MPs.
But we cannot refuse to pay taxes on something which is in the law. Otherwise, then you are running a country, one set of group of business people don't pay taxes, then this law applies to the other one.
But there's a group of people who want to pay tax because they know the penalty and the liability. They have not gone to court. So there are two groups of people.
Gobi fumbled to explain why the government stopped collection of taxes on raw gold exports, saying it was an initiative that aimed at promoting gold refinery.
We need to tax gold where value has been added.
Order, honorable.
Value added gold. We shouldn't tax raw gold. The incentive was to encourage all gold to be refined.
The Mining and Minerals Export Levy on Refined Gold Regulations 2023 imposed a levy of $200 per kilogram on processed gold to be exported outside of Uganda. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.